फिर गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ इकोन 365, दैट इज फार्म मैनेजमेंट प्रोडक्शन एंड रिसोर्स इकोनॉमिक्स। सो टुडेज आवर लेक्चर इज अबाउट द वेरियस इकोनॉमिक प्रिंसिपल्स अप्लाइड टू फार्म मैनेजमेंट। मीन्स दिस प्रिंसिपल्स हेल्प्स टू मैनेजिंग द फार्म वेरी इफिशियंटली। विच आर दोज प्रिंसिपल्स वी विल सी इन दिस लेक्चर। सो एज वी नो the outpouring of new technological information is making the farm problems increasingly challenging and providing the attractive opportunities for maximizing the profits. Hence, the application of economic principles to farming community or to farming industry is essential for the successful management of the farm businesses. So there are 7 principles that helps the manager in the rational farm management decisions or to taking the decisions related to farm management. So which are those principles? First principle is about the law of variable proportion or law of diminishing returns. As we have studied in a second semester course about the law of diminishing return, then second cost principle, third principle of factor substitution, fourth principle of product substitution, fifth principle of equi-marginal returns, 6th time comparison principle, and 7th principle of comparative advantage. Okay, so we will discuss the one by one. So the law of variable proportion or law of diminishing returns, that principle solves the problem of how much to produce. Okay, it guides the determination of optimum input to use and optimum output to produce. Okay, it explains, means law of variable proportion or law of diminishing returns explains the one of the basic production relationship, that is factor product relationship. Then second principle, cost principle. So cost principle explain how losses can be minimized during the period of price adversity. Okay, third principle of factor substitution. So this principle or this principle solves the problem of how to produce. Okay, it guides, or principle of factor substitution guides in the determination of least cost combination of the resources. It explains factor-factor relationship. Keep in mind, law of variable proportion or law of diminishing returns explains the or shows the factor product relationship, whereas principle of factor substitution explains the factor factor relationship. Then fourth principle of product substitution. So principle of product substitution solves the problem of what to produce. First one, first principle about the variable proportion, how much to produce. Second, third principle is about the factor substitution, means how to produce. And fourth, product substitution, means what to produce or which product we have to produce. So principle of product substitution guides in the determination of optimum combination of enterprises, that is products. So principle of product substitution explains product-product relationship. Then fifth one, principle of equi-marginal returns. So principle of equi-marginal returns guides in the allocation of resources under a conditions of scarcity. Okay, then sixth, time comparison principle. So time comparison principle guides in making investment decisions, means when we have to make an investment at a particular time. Okay, seventh, principle of comparative advantage. So it explains regional specialization in the production of the commodities, which commodity have a comparative advantage on other commodity. So this principle explains the regional specialization in the production of the different commodities. Now we'll see the first law of variable proportion or law of diminishing returns, or this law or this principle is also known as the principle of added cost and the added return. As we have learned in second semester, The law of diminishing return is a basic natural law affecting the many phases of management of the farm business. So as we have learned, this law of diminishing returns applied to agriculture sector. So the factor product relationship or the amount of resources that should be used means optimum input and consequently the amount of product that should be produced, that is optimum output, is directly related to the operation of law of diminishing returns. Means amount of input use and amount of product produce, that is optimum output, they are directly related to the law of diminishing marginal return. So this law derives its name from the fact that as a successive unit of variable resource are used in combination with the collection of fixed resources, the resulting additional to the total product will be become successively smaller. As we have seen in law of diminishing returns, as we add another unit, we get the less satisfaction. Similarly, if we add another unit of input to the farm enterprises, we will get the less output. So most profitable level of production, how to get the most profitable level of production? So first, in that, how much input to use, that is output input, optimum input to use, the determination of optimum input to use. How to determine the optimum input to use? It is an important use of information derived from a production function is in determining how much of variable input to use. Given a goal of maximizing profit, the farmer must select from all the possible input levels the one which will result in the greatest profit. Means farmer has a various combinations, or farmer has a choices of the input. From that input, farmer has a choose that input. From that input, he will get the maximum profit. Okay. To determine the optimum input to use, we apply two marginal concept or two simple concepts. These are the marginal value product, MVP, and a marginal factor cost, that is MFC. Okay. Now we will see in the example. What is marginal value product? Marginal value product. So, marginal value product is the additional income received from using an additional unit of input. What is MVP or marginal value product? Is the additional income received or received from the use of additional input. Okay. It is calculated by using formula. Marginal value product is equal to change in total value product divided by change in input level. What is the MVP? MVP is equal to change in total value product divided by change in input level. So MVP is equal to change in Y into PY, means price of Y, divided by change in X. So delta is the change, Y is equal to output, and PY is price per unit. So X is the, Y is the output, and X is the input. Okay. Now marginal input cost. What is marginal input cost or marginal factor cost? Okay. So it is defined as marginal input cost or marginal factor cost. It is the additional cost associated with the, or additional cost related with the use of additional output, additional unit of output, means the cost which is related to the additional unit of output, additional unit of input, is called as the marginal factor cost. Marginal means additional, the cost of additional unit of input is the marginal factor cost. So formula for marginal factor cost is equal to change in total input cost divided by change in input level. So what is formula? Change in X into PX divided by change in X. So change in x into px divided by change in x is equal to px, whereas x is the input quantity, px is the price unit of input. So marginal factor cost is constant and equal to the price per unit of the input. What is marginal factor cost? It is the price per unit of input. Okay, so this conclusion holds provided the input price does not change with the quantity of input purchase. Okay, so this is about the marginal value product and marginal factor cost. Now next is the decision rule, is that if how to determine the profitable or not profitable, if MVP, that is marginal value product, is greater than marginal input cost, the additional profit can be made by the using more input. Second, if MVP is less than marginal factor cost, more profit can be made by using the less input. And third one, profit maximizing or optimum input level is at the point where marginal value product is equal to marginal factor cost. Keep in mind, it may be asked for fill in the blanks. Profit maximizing or optimum input level is at the point where marginal value product is equal to marginal factor cost or marginal input cost. Okay, so delta y divided by delta x means change in y divided by change in x into py is equal to px change in y divided by change in x is equal to px divided by py. So we will see the example for determination of optimum input level. So here input price is 12 rupees per unit and output price is 2 rupees per unit. Here we can see the input level from 0 to 10, the total product TPP is there, MPP is there, TVP is there, MVP is there and MIC is there. Okay, these are the example of determination of optimum input level. Now we will see so the first few lines in the above table show that MVP to be greater than MIC. In other words, the additional income received from using additional unit of input exceed the additional cost of that input, therefore the additional profit is being made. So this relationship exists until the input level reaches to 6th unit. At this point or at this level, MVP is equal to MFC, means marginal factor cost. So it is a point of maximum returns or optimum output. Okay, using more than 6 units of input causes MVP to be less than MFC, which causes profit to decline as more input is used. Okay, the profit maximizing input level is therefore at the point where MVP is equal to MIC or MFC. Note that the profit maximizing point is not at the point at the input level which maximizes the total value product. Profit is maximized at a lower input level. Now, how much output to be produced means optimum output. So, the determination of output, optimum output to produce, to answer this question requires the introduction to new marginal concept, that is marginal revenue and marginal cost. So what is marginal revenue? So marginal revenue is the additional income from selling the additional unit of output. What is marginal revenue? Marginal means additional. Marginal revenue is the additional income from selling the additional unit of production or additional unit of output. So marginal revenue is calculated as a marginal revenue is equal to change in total revenue divided by change in the total physical product, that is TPP. So marginal returns is equal to change in TR divided by change in Y. So marginal revenue or MR is equal to change in YY divided by change in Y. So is equal to PY, whereas Y is equal to output and PY is the price per unit of output. So total revenue is same as the total value product. Okay. So MR is a constant and equal to the price per unit of output. So this is relation. Keep in mind, total revenue is same as the total value product, and MR is constant and equal to the price per unit of output. Next, what is marginal cost? This is about the marginal revenue. Now, what is marginal cost? So marginal cost is the additional cost incurred from producing an additional unit of output, means cost required for producing additional unit of output is the marginal cost. So marginal cost is calculated as marginal cost is equal to change in total cost divided by change in total physical product. So MC, marginal cost, is equal to change in X into PX divided by change in Y, whereas X is the quantity of input and PX is the price per unit of input. Now, what is decision rule regarding this? If marginal revenue is greater than marginal cost, additional profit can be made by producing the more input, and if marginal revenue is less than marginal cost, more profits can be made by producing the less output. So the profit maximizing output level is at the point where MR is equal to MC, where MR is equal to MC. Okay. Now example for here, input price is 2 rupees per out per unit of output, and output price is 2 rupees per unit. See here, the input level is from 1 to 10 TPP, MPP, TVP, MR, marginal returns and marginal cost. Here we can see the marginal returns is a constant as a 2 to 2, and marginal cost firstly goes on decreasing up to 4th unit, 4 input level. After 4th input level, it goes on the increasing. In case of MPP, firstly it is increasing up to the 4th unit. After 4th unit, it goes on decreasing, and after 8th unit of input level, it is become a negative. So in the above table, it is clear that MR is greater than MC up to the output level of 62 units, means up to the 5th input level. At the point at the output level of 68, the MR is equal to MC, means marginal cost at the 6th unit or at the 6th input level, the marginal revenue is equal to the marginal cost. So this is the optimum output level. This is the optimum output to be produced, means up to at the 6th input level, we can get the maximum returns or optimum output from that investment. If we produce 72 units, means at the 7th level, at the 7th input level of output, additional revenue from additional output is less than the input. Okay. So this is about the principles. Now for this course, you can refer the book of VT Raju and Rao, that is Economics of Farm Production and Management, and another book by the Zohar and Kapoor, that is Fundamentals of Farm Business Management. Thank you.